it up in the water. If it owls your mind, you might not keep going. You pick the rainfall and listen.
Yes, hey, look me over. Land me in here. Fresh out of clover, mortgage up to here. Don't pass the plate, folks. Don't pass the cup. I figure whenever you're down and out, the only way is up. And I'll be up like a rosebud, high on the vine. Don't thumb your nose, but take a tip of mine. I'm a little bit short of the elbow room, but let me get me some. And look out, well, yeah, I got.
When it sinks into me that we lost, I go into deep depression for about a week. At least a week, okay? And usually it takes about a week for me for it to sink in.
Fanaticism has been defined as redoubling your effort when you have forgotten your aim. It does not describe an LSU fan. He does not bark like they do in Georgia or call pigs as in Arkansas. His support is resolute, not to be confused with the exuberance of a college student who is blowing off steam. That you outgrow. The fans we are surveying have grown into something. Psychologists explain it as extended childhood, tribal instinct, territorial imperative, and other nonsense. One expert has even measured stress during a game, and not surprisingly, discovered that a real fan often goes through the same emotional hell as a player. That certainly applies to Augie Cross, president of the year-round Tiger Booster Club. Once, a friend suggested that Tulane had a decent football team. Augie didn't speak to him for 3 weeks.
When they lose, we bleed, we cry. It's the same like one time we lost in Florida, and I didn't want to come back. I just, you feel like dying, honestly.
It actually reaches somewhat beyond the grave, at least with a Baton Rouge woman who recently willed that her ashes be sprinkled over Tiger Stadium during an Ole Miss game. Compared to that, the method Jim LeBlanc's family has chosen for support is positively introverted. Mrs. LeBlanc designed these outfits and got the idea for the Tiger fur from watching Doc Severinsen on TV. On the whole, the LeBlancs are well received at LSU's sporting events, but report that in Tennessee, some jerks did throw soft drinks all over them. Maybe the answer is to choose something less obvious, like socks.
The unusual thing, I go, if I have to go to a doctor's office, to a dentist, and I walk in the office and I sit down and I pick up a magazine to read and cross my legs, I feel very self-conscious because everybody in the waiting room seems to be staring at my socks with blue suit or brown.
This is Harold Pelias, another dyed-in-the-wool LSU fan. To be precise, writ number 18 dyed in the wool. That is the color purple.
I have left the book a little reserved, not too much, but as you'll notice, it'll be different colors.
I don't wear anything where I'm working, going to funerals, wakes, weddings.
And this degree of enthusiasm obviously has to spill out of the sock drawer and onto the walls and doors.
I don't believe I did. I think my son did it. This was, a combination of loss to Tulane or a tie with Rice. One of the LSU basketball games. I think the radio was damaged to where he had to buy himself another transistor radio to listen to the.
Graphic support is not limited to interior design, or in this case, redesign. For example, Curly Brissett in New Orleans East is well known because of the outside of his house. As is often true with the more demonstrative fans, individual expression of support is not as much a measure of love for LSU as it is the parameters of a wife's patience.
We started moving a little slowly. We just came in with the drapes in the house, and we had the gold sofa and the carpet and a few pictures. The ambition, what I'd like to, I don't know if I should say this on camera, but what I'd really like to do is have something on a roof as a Tiger stepping out of the stadium and under that Death Valley. That's my last ambition.
This proclivity to Lebensraum has forced some wives, do we dare call them tigerettes, to limit the fan to one room, combined with a vigorous program of containment. Jack Andoni, a New Orleans physician, is an example. Here is an instance where a broken washing machine spawned a museum.
We had a garage in our previous house, and a hose on a washing machine burst. It flooded three rooms of carpet. So we had to throw the carpet out in the garage. And I just asked my wife one day, why don't we get a purple rug or a gold rug and make a purple and gold room out of it? And she thought I was crazy. My involvement is also good therapy for me. I don't have any hobbies. I don't golf or fish or do a lot of things. My hobby happens to be LSU. So in a way, I guess it's therapy for me too.
Talk about beating them tigers.